캐드를 하는 데 있어서 캐드가 뭐예요? 캐드에 막 치수 주고 이러죠. 그러니까 이게 설계 디자인 이렇게 이런 거 하는 거예요. 그렇기 때문에 그 기계공차 GD&T 이게 엄청 중요하거든요. GD&T도 막 이거 이것저것 막 인터넷 보고 블로그 보고 유튜브 보고 뭐책 보고 해도 기계공차의 바이블이 있고 바이블보다 조금 안타까운 것도 있고 뭐 이런 거 있잖아요, 책마다. 근데 제일 좋은 책을 제가 구해왔습니다. 그래서 한번 읽으면서 제가 해석이 가능하면 해석도 하고 해석이 안 되면 그냥 읽기만 하겠습니다. 책 읽어주는 캐드 튜터가 되는 거죠, 이제. 이제 딱 여기 시작이에요. 여기가 Allowances and Tolerance for Fit. 맞춤을 위한 호용과 공차 이렇게 되겠죠. Limit and Fit. 한계와 맞춤. Fits between cylindrical parts. For example, cylindrical fits govern the proper assembly and performance of many mechanisms. Clearance fit permit relative freedom of motion between a shaft and a hole, axially, radially, or both. 지금 이게 지금 초반에 이제 들어가는 개론이잖아요. 그러니까 뭐 실린더 알죠? 실린더 부품 같은 거뭐 이게 뭐 이런 데 사용된다고요. 뭐 축축이나 뭐 원형이나 뭐그두둘둘다 모든 케이스. Interference fits secure a certain amount of tightness between parts, whether these are meant to remain permanently assembled or to be taken apart from time to time. 아, 이거 지금 제가 직업이 해석하는 사람이 아니니까 뭐책뭐뭐 역자도 아니고 책 읽어주는 남자로 하겠습니다. 그러니까 뭐 예를 들어 요즘에 오디오북 많이 나오죠. 책 읽어주는 남자니까 천천히 읽으니까 뭐 어려운 단어도 아니니까 딱 공대 용어는 다 이게 다 비슷비슷하니까 다 알아들을 거라고 믿습니다. 천천히 읽겠습니다. 책 읽어주는 3D 캐드 튜터예요. Or again, two parts may be required to fit together smugly, without apparent tightness or looseness. The designer's problem is to specify these different types of fits in such a way that the shop can produce them. Establishing the specifications requires the adoption of two manufacturing limits for the hole and two for the shaft, and hence the adoption of a manufacturing tolerance on each part. In selecting and specifying limits and fits for various applications, it is essential in the interest of interchangeable manufacturing that first, standard definitions of terms relating to limits and fits to be used. Second, preferred basic sizes be selected wherever possible to reduce material and tooling costs. Third, limits be based upon a series of preferred tolerances and allowances. And fourth, a uniform system of applying tolerances, preferably unilateral, be used. These principles have been incorporated in both the American and British standards for limits and fit. Information about these standards is given beginning on page 600. 46. Basic size. The basic size of a screw thread or machine part is the theoretical or nominal standard size from which variations are made. For example, a shaft may have a basic diameter of 2 inches, but a maximum variation of minus 0.010 inch may be permitted. The minimum hole should be of basic size wherever the use of standard tools represents the greatest economy. The maximum shaft should be of basic size wherever the use of standard purchased material without further machining represents the greatest economy. Even though special tools are required to machine the mating part. 이게 뭐, tolerances. Tolerance is the amount of variation permitted on dimensions of surfaces of machine parts. The tolerance is equal to the difference between the maximum and minimum limits of any specified dimension. For example, if the maximum limit of the diameter of a shaft is 2.000 inches and its minimum limit is 1.990 inches, the tolerance for this diameter is 10 tau inch. The extent of this tolerance is established by determining the maximum and minimum clearances required on operating surfaces. As applied to the fitting of machine parts, the word tolerance means the amount that duplicate parts are allowed to vary in size in connection with manufacturing operations. Owing to unavoidable imperfections of workmanship. Tolerance may also be defined as the amount that duplicate parts are permitted to vary in size to secure sufficient accuracy without unnecessary refinement. The terms tolerance and allowance are often be interchangeably, but according to common usage, allowance is a difference in dimensions prescribed to secure various classes of fits between different parts. For information on factors involved in and various methods of calculating tolerances, see tolerance analysis and assignment on page 684. Unilateral and bilateral tolerances. The term unilateral tolerance means that the total tolerance as related to a basic dimension is in one direction only. For example, if the basic dimension were 1 inch and the tolerance were expressed as 1.000 to 0.002 or as 1.000 plus 0.002, this would be unilateral tolerances between the total tolerance in each is in one direction. On the contrary, if the tolerance were divided as to be partly plus and partly minus, it will be classified as bilateral. Thus, 1.000 plus 0.001 minus 0.001 is an example of bilateral tolerance because the total tolerance of 0.002 is given in two directions, plus and minus. When unilateral tolerances are used, one of the following three methods should be used express them. 1. Specify limiting dimensions only as diameter of hole, like 2.25 diameter of shaft, 2.249, 2.247. Second, one limiting size may be specified with each tolerance, this as diameter of hole, 2.250 plus 2 tau minus 0.000. Diameter of shaft 2.249 plus 0.000 minus 0.002. 3. The nominal size may be specified for both parts, with a notion showing both allowance and tolerance as diameter of hole 2 inch and a quarter plus 0.002, comma minus 0.000. Diameter of shaft 2 inch and a quarter minus 0.001, comma minus 0.003. Bilateral tolerances should be specified as such, usually with plus and minus tolerances of equal amount. An example of the expression of bilateral tolerances is 2 plus minus 0.002 or 2 plus 0.001 minus 0.001. Application of tolerances. According to common practice, tolerances are applied in such a way as to show the permissible amount of dimensional variation in the direction that is less dangerous. When a variation in either direction is equally dangerous, a bilateral tolerance should be given. When a variation in one direction is more dangerous than variation in another, a unilateral tolerance should be given in the less dangerous direction. For non-rotating surfaces or atmospheric fits, the tolerances may be bilateral or unilateral, depending entirely upon the nature of the variations that develop in manufacture. On mating surfaces, with few exceptions, the tolerances should be unilateral. Where tolerances are required on the distances between holes, usually they should be bilateral, as variation in either direction is normally equally dangerous. The variation in the distance between shafts carrying gears, however, should always be unilateral, and plus, otherwise the gears might run too tight. A slight increase in the backlash between gears is seldom of much importance. One exception to the use of unilateral tolerances on mating surfaces occurs when tapers are involved. Either bilateral or unilateral tolerances may then prove advisable, depending upon conditions. These tolerances should be determined in the same manner as the tolerances on the distances between holes. When a variation either in or out of the position of the mating taper surfaces is equally dangerous, the tolerances should be bilateral. When a variation in one direction is of less danger than a variation in the opposite direction, the tolerance should be unilateral and in the less dangerous direction. 허허, 이거 막, 와, 이거 엄청난 이거 노하우를 전수해 주네요. 네, 다음, locating tolerance dimensions. Only one dimension in the same straight line can be controlled within fixed limit. That dimension is the distance between the cutting surface of the tool and the locating or registering surface of the part being machined. Therefore, it is incorrect to locate any point or surface with tolerances from more than one point in the same straight line. Every part of a mechanism must be located in each plane. Every operating part must be located within proper operating allowances. After such requirements of location are met, all other surfaces should have liberal clearances. Dimensions should be given between those points or surfaces that it is essential to hold in a specific relation to each other. This restriction applies particularly to those surfaces in each plane that control the location of other opponent parts. Many dimensions are relatively unimportant in this respect. It is good practice to establish a common locating point in each plane and give as far as possible all such dimensions from this common locating point. The locating points on the drawing, the locating or registering points used for machining and surfaces, and the locating point for measuring should all be identical. 오늘이 이제 마지막 장입니다. 이게 시리즈예요. 이거 책세쪽 읽었다고 기계공학 전부가 아니겠죠? 이거 아주 바이블이니까 잘 들으세요. 같이 봅시다. The initial dimensions placed on component drawings should be the exact dimensions that would be used if it is possible to work without tolerances. Tolerances should be given in the direction in which variations will cause the least harm or danger. When a variation in either direction is equally dangerous, the tolerances should be of equal amount in both directions or bilateral. The initial clearances or allowances between operating parts should be as small as the operation of the mechanism will permit. The maximum clearance should be as great as the proper functioning of the mechanism will permit. Direction of tolerances on gauges. The extreme sizes for all plane limit gauges shall not exceed the extreme limit of the part to be gauged. All variations in the gauges, whatever their cause or purpose, shall bring these gauges within this extreme limit. The data for gauge tolerances on page 673 cover gauges to inspect workpieces held to tolerances in the American National Standard ANSI B4.4M-1981 withdrawal. Allowance for forced fit. The allowance per inch of diameter usually ranges from 0.001 inch to 0.0025 inch, 0.0254 to 0.0635 millimeter, 0.0015 inch 밀리미터로 할 때는 0.0381 밀리미터, being a fair average. Ordinarily, the allowance per inch decreases as the diameter increases. Thus, the total allowance for a diameter of 2 inches, 밀리미터 할 때는 50.8 밀리미터 might be 0.00인치, 밀리미터로는 0.102 밀리미터. Whereas for a diameter of 8 inches or 203.2 millimeter, the total allowance might not be over 0.009 or 0.010 inch, or 0.23 or 0.25 millimeter. The parts to be assembled by force fits are usually made cylindrical, although sometimes they are slightly tapered. Advantages of the tapered form are the possibility of abrasion of the fitted surface is reduced, less pressure is required in assembling, and parts are more readily separated when renewal is required. On the other hand, the taper fit is less reliable because it is loosened. The entire fit is free with but little axial movement. Some lubricant, such as white lead and lard oil, mixed to the consistency of paint, should be applied to the pin and bore before assembly to reduce the tendency toward abrasion. Pressure for forced fit. The pressure required for assembling cylindrical parts depends not only upon the allowance for the fit, but also upon the area of the fitted surfaces, the pressure increasing in proportion to the distance that the inner member is forced in. The approximate ultimate pressure in tons can be determined by the use of the following formula in conjunction with the accompanying table of pressure factors for forced fit. Assuming that A equal area of surface in contact in feet, A equal total allowance in inches, P equal ultimate pressure required in tons, F equal pressure factor based upon assumption that the diameter of the hub is twice the diameter of the bore, that the shaft is of machined steel, and that the hub is of cast iron. 공식 봅시다. P는 2분의 A 곱, 대문자 A 곱하기 소문자 A 곱하기 대문자 F. 아까 여기 설명드렸죠? 예, 이게 뭐 A는 total allowance in inches, 대문자 A는 area of surface in contact 이런 거요. 이게 이제 표예요. Pressure factors of force fit. 여기 좌측 칼럼에는 다이아미터, 이게 뭐 1인치부터 3.25인치까지 프레셔 팩터는 이제 이게 나오네요. 먼저 다음 칼럼에는 다이아미터 인치, 프레셔 팩터 다이아미터 인치. 이게 한 이렇게 표로 이렇게 나와져 있고요. 이 유튜브 장점이 뭡니까? 시청각이 가능하잖아요. 이 표를 어떻게 읽어줘요? 이거 표를 이렇게 표 왜냐면 좌우가 매칭되는 거잖아요. 눈으로 보는 게 빠르죠, 이거는? 유튜브의 장점입니다. 다음, 이제. Allowance for given pressure by transposing the preceding formula, the approximate allowance for a required ultimate tonnage can be determined. Thus, A equal 2P over AF. The average ultimate pressure in tons commonly used ranges from 7 to 10 times the diameter in inches. 이거 노하우 장난 아니네요. 표도 마찬가지고. 이게 뭐 다이아미터에 따른 압력 뭐 이런 거 프레스핏 할때 이런 거다 알려주네요. 이게 자 이게 시청도 해주시고 저거 뭐냐 듣기도 해주셔서 책 읽어주는 3D 캐드 2편이었습니다. 이게 딱 카파할 테니까. 많은 시청, 응원, 구독, 그리고 공유 부탁드립니다. 감사합니다.